Hello, my dear students, I hope you all are doing well. So today I'm going to start the continuation of exercise 6A. Okay, so in the previous video we have completed till question number 7. Now today I'm going to start from question number 8. So in question number 8 we have arrange the following decimals, okay, so the first question we have, question number 8, arrange the following decimal numbers in order of size starting with large. So some decimal numbers are given there. We have to arrange that decimal numbers in order of their largest to smallest. So starting from largest, starting with largest, it is mentioned in the question. So the first question we have 4.893, next we have 7.983, then next we have 7.909, next we have 7.913. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, so the first question we have here 4.893, 7.983, then 7.909, then 7.913. So here we have to start from largest to smallest. Okay, we have to arrange this decimal number from largest to smallest. So if we compare this given of decimals, okay, here we have 4.89, here we have 7.98, here we have 7.90, here we have 7.91. So if you see these three numbers, okay, all are in sevens line, okay, 7.98, 7.90, 7.91. Now first number is same in all these three cases. Now we have to compare the next number. After decimal point we have here 98, okay, after decimal here we have 98, here 90, here 91. So 98, 90, 91, which one is the greatest? 98 is the greatest. So first number will be 7.983. okay, solution part. Okay, now after 98, after decimal point 98, next we have 90 and 91. Among these two, 90 and 91, 91 is bigger. So next number will be 7.913. Then after that we have 7.909. And the last one we have 4.893. Because 4 is smaller than 7. So we are starting from greatest to smallest. So this is the answer for the first question of subpart question number 8. Here 7.983, 7.913, 7.909, then last one will be 4.893. So this is very easy. First you have to compare the unit place number tens, and after that we have to go for 10th, 100th place. If the value are greater, then we have to arrange accordingly, okay, and the smaller will be at the last. Okay, next question we have, question number 3, okay. From this question number 8, we are going to do question number 3, subpart, okay. So out of that 3, 2 questions I am solving and the 1 will be your homework. So next question we have, 0.0710, 0.0171, 0.1007, 0.0071, here 0.0107. Now here also, we have to arrange the following decimals number in order of their size, okay, from largest to smallest. So largest, we have to choose the largest one. Now here in all these four cases we can see that in unit place we have 0 0 0, so all are same. Now next we will see the next after decimal point, we will check that number. So here is 0, here also 0, here is 1, okay, here also we have 0 and 0. Now first, second, third. In third case we can see that after decimal point we have 1, but in the other cases, other four cases, we have 0 0 0 0 0. So compared to 0, 1 is greater than 0. So what we'll do that we will write first this number 0.1007. Okay, this is your solution part. So in first place, the largest one is 0.1007. Okay, after 1007, next we have to choose the number. Okay, if you compare these two decimal, we have 0.7. Here 0.1. Here 10. Here 10. Here 00. Here 01. So among all these cases, 0.7, okay, 0.7 is greater than 0.1, it is greater than 00, it is greater than 0.1. So next number will be 0.0710, okay. So this is the first place, this is in the second place. Now next we will compare for third place. So here we have 0.017, okay, 0.017. Now here we have 0.10. So if we compare these three numbers after decimal, we can see that 0.17 and 0.10. So 0.017 is greater than 0.010. So in third place we have 0.017. okay, now next we have this number 0.0107, and in last the smallest one we have 0.0071. so this is the way to arrange the decimal numbers from largest to smallest. Okay, so now next number we have question number 9. So in question number 9 again we have arranged the following decimal numbers in order of size with smallest first. So here we have to choose the, we have to arrange from smallest to largest decimal. So now we have to compare all this, okay, we have to compare all this decimal number. Now the smallest one, if you check here 3.07, 3.47, 4.16. so we have to see the threes line 1 2 3. Okay, decimals are there, okay, three decimal numbers are there and with starting with 3, okay, starting with 3. So now next after decimal we have to compare. So after decimal we have 0.07, after decimal we have 4.7, and here after decimal we have 9.3. so the smallest one is 0.7. so first number will be 3.07. okay, this is your solution part. Now next after 0.7, which one is the greater one? 3.47. so next will be 3.47. after 3.47 next we have 3.93. okay, now next we have two number 4.16 and here we have 4.61. okay, now we are arranging from smallest to largest. So among these two numbers, this one is the smallest one. So next we have 4.16 and the last one we have 4.61. so this is the way to arrange the decimal numbers from smallest to largest. So we have to choose the smallest first. Okay, next part of this question number 9, I am doing question number 3. So again from this question number 9, question number 2 will be your homework. So here also, arrange the following decimal numbers in order of size with the smallest first. So we have to choose the smallest first. Okay, now if you compare all these numbers here, 3.3, here 3.03, 0.33, 0.03, 0.303, 3.003. So the smallest one, okay? If you compare all these numbers, the smallest one we have 0.03. So we'll write first 0. Solution part we have 0.03. Then after 0.03 we have 0.30. So next number will be 0.303. Okay, after 0.30, 30. So after 30 we have 33. So here it will be 0.33. Now after 0.33 we have 3.003, and here we have 3.03. So this one will be smaller. So this number will come first. So 3.003. Next one we have 3.03. And the last one we have 3.3. So this is the answer for this question number 9.3. Okay, next question number 10 we have, write as a fraction, okay? It is given in a decimal number, now we have to write it in the fraction form. So first one we have 0.53. Now here, after decimal point, how many digits we have? 2, okay? We have 2 digits. So here, we can write this one as 53/100. If there are 2 digits after decimal, we have to put 20, okay? 20. Now here, in question number 3, we have, after decimal, how many digits we have? 1, 2, 3. So what we'll do that, we'll write 903/1, 2, 3. Why this 30? Because after decimal we have 3 numbers, 1, 2, 3, okay? 3 digits, that's why we are writing 3 zeros after this decimal. Now question number 5, we have 0.00069. Now count it, after decimal how many digits we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we'll write 0.00069/1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Or this can be written as 69/1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this can be written as 69/1, 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000, 1,000,000. Okay? Why this 0, 0 is not there? Because there is no value for 0 before any number. So we can write this one as 69/1,000,000. So here also same thing, we have not written this 0, so we have directly written 903/1,000. Okay, why 30? Because after decimal we have 3 digits. So this is the way to write, okay, the decimal numbers in the fraction form. Okay, next question we have, question number 12. Convert the following fraction to decimals by changing the denominator to 10 or multiple of 10. So here what we have to do that, the fraction are given, we have to convert it to decimal, but here we have to make this denominator as multiple of 10, okay, multiple of 10. So I will teach you how to convert this one into multiple of 10. Now first question we have 11/5. So 11/5, I can write this one as 11/5. Now if I multiply this 5 with 10 and here also with 10, then now it will become the multiple of 10. So I can write this number 11 times 110, 110/50, okay, 110/50. Now if you divide this 110/50, okay, what will get? That will get 2.2. So that dividing part you have to check it, okay? So we'll get 2.2. Now 2.2 is a decimal number. Similarly, next we'll try question number 3. And remember one thing, in this question number 12, we have total 6 or 7 questions. Out of that, 3 I will solve and the remaining one you have to do it by yourself. So that one will be your homework. Now, next we have 19 by 25. So here also we have to do the same. We have to make this 25 as multiple of 10. Now, 19 by 25. Now, in order to make the multiple of 10, I can do one thing. I can multiply this one by 4. Here also, the numerator by 4. Now, next step, 25 into 4. If you try here, 25 into 4. 4, 5 is 20. 0, carry 2. 4 to the 8 plus 2, 10. So, how much we are getting? We are getting 100. Now, 100 is a multiple of 10. Now, we will do the same for this 19 into 4. Okay? 19 into 4. So, 9, 4 is 36. 6, carry 3. 4, 1 is 4 plus 3, 7. So, we will get here 76 by 100. Now, 76 by 100. So here, how many 0 we have? 2. So after this 2 number, decimal point. So it will be 0.76. Because this 2 0 will be placed before this 76. So it will be counted at 0.76. Similarly, we will do it for this question number 5. We have 43 by 125. Now this can be written as 43 by 125. Now we have to make this 125 as multiple of 10. So when we multiply this one with 8, in the numerator part also we have to multiply with 8. So here, if we multiply 125 into 8, we will get 1000, okay? We will get 1000 and here 43, we can multiply 43 into 8. 43 into 8. So 8 is 24, 4 carry 2. 4 8 is 32 plus 2. 32, 33, 34. How much we are getting? 34. So we are getting 3, 4, 4. Now check it. How to convert this one into a decimal number? So below we have 3, 0. Okay. So this decimal point will be placed before this 3 numbers or 3 digits. So here we can write this one 0.344. Why this one is 0.344? Because we can see that how many zeros are there? We have 3 zeros. So here this decimal point will be placed before 3 digits. So it will be counted at 0.344. So this is the way to solve or to convert this one fraction into a decimal. Okay. So next class we will start exercise 6B.